Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Shaniqua Vereen. This week we heard from a record-breaking astronaut, a solar eclipse took place, and we dove deep into science. After 371 days in space, NASA astronaut Frank Rubio had a press conference discussing his mission where he became the record holder for longest single spaceflight by a U.S. astronaut.
Every individual obviously is very different, right? So I think we'll all handle it very differently. For me, again, to some degree, I was lucky in my military background. I've had missions extended. I've had plenty of friends and family that have been under much more duress and much more difficult conditions who've been extended. And so it was somewhat difficult to feel sorry for myself in that situation. But, it helped tremendously to have an incredible community around us. And I knew that my family was, not only were they showing a lot of resilience and strength, but the community around us was just, they just did so much, so much prayer, support. It was really almost overwhelming how much love and support we received.
If you were in the Americas last weekend, there was a good chance that you saw the annular solar eclipse.
Wow.
The eclipse was visible to millions of people in the path of the astronomical event. For the crew aboard the space station, they got not only to witness the moon passing between the Earth and the sun, but they also saw the eclipse shadow on the surface of our planet. But the crew did much more than just look at moon shadows this week. Astronaut Satoshi Furukawa exchanged science samples inside the JAXA electrostatic levitation furnace. The ELF provides thermophysical properties around high melting temperatures that are not obtainable on the ground. ESA astronaut Andreas Mogensen evaluated a new lighting system. The circadian light investigation compares this new system to the current lighting aboard the station to help astronauts maintain an acceptable circadian rhythm. And NASA astronaut Laura O'Hara performed several ultrasound scans in support of CIPHER, an effort to learn how the entire human body adapts to spaceflight. CIPHER is key to NASA's plan to safely send humans deep into space. And that's Space to Ground for now. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.